Day at a time. so that you get down. So Missy will just be in your hands after we do this.
Okay, I have one prayer request this morning for Ronnie Martinez family from Farmington, New Mexico. It's a friend of Belinda and Larry's. They rode motorcycles together. He hit a deer this morning and he passed. And the passenger, we don't know. We think it's in the hospital. We don't know. But please pray for them and Larry and Belinda.
Good morning.
Morning.
Is it not great to be in church today? Even though we're having to be socially distanced, I'm so glad that we're here today. And what an amazing day to recognize that we have Mother's Day and Seniors Recognition Day on the same day. And so all the mothers of these great kids, I'd like you to stand up. I'm standing up already. Good God. So, Ron asked me and Terrell asked me to do this, and this morning on the way to town, I was like, oh gosh, I don't want to get through this. Anyway, thank you guys for loving on these kids.
Kids are church baby.
Riley was our church baby. Even Carson used to sit in the front and eat Cheerios at the front right behind us, right there in front of David and the make noise, and David never cared, did he? So anyway, guys, I just want to encourage y'all to keep up your faith. Be strong, y'all are great kids. I love every one of you. Anyway, this church loves y'all, and for those of you that are staying at Vernon College, you can still come to my Sunday school class. Just because you graduated doesn't mean you can't come anymore. I'm excited to see you guys there, but love y'all, and we've got a gift from the church each one of y'all, and that's all I can say. Thank you.
Joining the U.S. Marine Corps, and he leaves June 15th.
Take it well.
I'm going to Vernon for 2 years, and then I'm going to four-year college, and then get my coaching degree.
As I said, we're just walking this thing by faith. And seniors, thank y'all. Thank y'all for coming. Let me read a passage of scripture for you seniors, okay? I will lift my eyes to the mountains, for whence shall my help come? My help comes from the Lord who made heaven and earth. He will not allow your foot to slip. He will keep you. He will not let you be in slumber. Behold, he who keeps Israel, and neither slumber nor sleep also. Let's pray again for our seniors. Heavenly Father, we thank you for these boys and girls. We thank you for the young people. We thank you for their lives that they experienced, and that we had the opportunity all these years to rub shoulders with them and to guide them in their daily walk of life. Lord, be with them as they start a new adventure in their life. They go to a new place. And Lord, our prayer is to be with them daily, moment by moment. For we pray it in the name of Jesus. Amen.
Okay, if you'll turn to page 5. And as you're turning to page 5, I would like to extend a huge thank you from the Kobe Peterson family and Terry Birmingham for all of your prayers. You'll please continue to pray for the families, but they are very appreciative, because without all of you, without all of your prayers, we would have never made it. Page 5.
My burden share.
Thank you. let's turn over to page 149. 149. You knew me too well, didn't you?
Bear with us. We're going to get through this thing. We're traveling things, roads that we haven't traveled before. But thank you all for coming. Missy, thank you for passing that out to the senior seniors. Thank you for being here and coming here and letting us be part of your life all these years. We appreciate it. We sure do. If you're a mom, stand up. Just stay standing. We're going to give you guys a big hand because you're The, you know, I want to share with you just a brief moment this morning about the characteristics of a woman. And I'm going to illustrate my wife. I didn't ask her if I could do this. I'm just doing it. When you're married to someone 68, 63 years, you can do anything you want. That doesn't mean you won't get in trouble, but you can attempt to do anything you want. 63 years ago, my wife and I surrendered to preach at Dumas, Texas, to preach the Word of God, to follow him in Berkeley. He followed us. And then he took us to college, took us to seminary, and took us to different churches throughout the time, throughout the area. Went all the way to San Antonio once, and that was enough. I said, Lord, don't take this old country boy out and you know, like this anymore. And but anyway, I want to share with you the characteristics of a woman, of a mother. Number one, the mother has a gift of love. And the way that you have a gift of love is as you reveal it and you show it. And you show it all the time. We have three kiddos, David, Phil, and we have Linda. In fact, we're going down to their house, to Linda's house, and Phil and them are going to meet us there, and we're going to celebrate moms being a mom. And Latrell fits that situation. She fits that situation of being a mother. If you're in the house, and she's talking to one of the kids, one of the grandkids, one of the great-grandkids, it doesn't make any difference. She'll always close it, I love you. She'll use that every time, I love you. And that's part of her characteristic is she reveals the love in her life, the love of God in her life. And she exhibits this in the way that she talks, the way that she walks. And then another characteristic that she has is she had a characteristic of sharing goodwill. And in other words, always positive, always upbeat. She's always upbeat with the kids, with the grandkids. In fact, she just got through calling all the grandkids, and that's getting to be a job. Grandkids and great-grandkids, I mean, you're on the phone all the time. But anyway, she just got off the phone, calling them up to see if they're okay and give them an encouraging word. This is part of the characteristics of her life, of how she reveals to people. And you know, she's got a pretty good quiverful because she's got the grandkids, she's got the great-grandkids, and now she's working on the great-great-grandkids. All right? That's his full house. One great. Who's one? Help me. Okay, great. I'm sorry. Well, that's coming. That's coming. But anyway, moms, you are so important to be an encourager, to be an uplifter to your family, to guide your family, to direct your family, because your family leans on you. Your family kind of checks on you to see what's going on, and therefore you're very important to the wives. So mom, you play a very, very important role in your family life. You are so important. And another thing that my wife is strong on is that she wants to know that her little family all knows the Lord is her Savior. And for God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, that whosoever believes in him will not perish, but will have everlasting life. And a mom has characteristics of the love of God, of being an encourager, also encourages her family to read the Word, to study the Word of God, to pass the Word of God throughout her family all the time. If you call my wife, she's going to be sharing with you scripture and share with you what it means and what it means to you. So, Mom, your work is cut out for you. You're very, very important. You're very important to this church, and you're very important to your local family, and so important. And thank you for putting up with us tonight, today, this morning. And we're going to dismiss you here in just a moment, but it's going to be a little different. We're going to dismiss you in rows, like you do when you go to a funeral. Okay? This is not a funeral. But we're going to dismiss you in rows. And I'm going to ask Dewey if he'll take the spot right there at the back. But before you get quiet and start dismissing them, let's go to the Lord in prayer and let's remember our moms. Heavenly Father, thank you for this privilege today. Thank you for honoring our mothers. Some of them are still living. Some of them have gone to be with the Lord. And Lord, we accept either one. And we just say thank you, Lord, for giving us our moms the time and the short time that we have. And Lord, thank you for this service this morning, that we can honor the mothers and we can honor the seniors. And Lord, we thank you for this. We thank you for your guidance. For we pray it in the name of Jesus. Amen. The band's going to be playing, so go take off.
I have one little footnote to write about this self-home quarantine. I've had more home cooking in the last 4, 5, or 6 weeks than I've had in probably 20 years. So that's got pretty good. I made one more mistake. I made this song for this last night. And I was thinking, hey, shall we gather at the river? But I put elk and gather when we have a shallow father in the river. See you. Good to see all you people. Missed you. We're going to do baby letters.